I mean, you're going to be very disappointed because you've left them all standing, but you've picked up what time has been. The time 80.13. The time of that 79 seconds. Stop. We're going next to Emmy Maloney. Join us with Quintuplicate. That's on the time we're getting it by Cobra Brigade. Combination that were fifth here just a few weeks ago in the Glencarrig qualifier here at Barnadan.
Jump in after the trip and set up and then that amount.
That succeeds every four times. We're going to do number three. It's Elena Hawkins now who joins us with Valley Duffler. This one is a Nature of Gatling by the Head Canal Prince. It is, in fact, a Connemara, purebred Connemara pony.
Okay.
Well, let's say jumping penalties, three time penalties for Lena Hawkins and Bally Duffler. Well, next to join us in the Shield Direct Arena, it's a Joshua Project. He takes up with a Dexter and Death Affair. This one, a French bread by Double DM. Well, there is. That's our first clear. Well done. Clear for Joshua Broderick. And take care. This is back. Now, just before we let the next one go, the time allowed has now been extended to 82 seconds. So it's 82 seconds, so that means number one, Josephine Dale, that is a clear. So now we have two clears, Josephine Dale and Joshua Broderick. So do remember, the new time allowed, 82 seconds. Number 5, Sarah Egan now joins with Rebel Gaelic. Another one here registered with the Connemara Pony Breeders Society. Oh, well, that is clear. So we've now got three clears, clear for Sir Egan and Reverend Quaylock. So, Juliana, we're just going to hold you for just for a half moment. We need to check something before we let you go. Well, at the moment, three clears in our 1-3 qualifier as we go to number 6. Juliana Nelson now, and Dynamo Duro. Well, it's four jumping, but there's also one time penalty for Juliana Nelson and Dynamo Duro. So we go next to number 7, Piana McAvoy now, and Etoile du Chisinau. That was 6th in the Bob Sweeney Future Champion Series at Banbridge just a few weeks ago.
Thank you.
around number four here in our first round clear. Burkina back a boy, and a trois du Chesnay. Well, on we go now here in the Childeric Arena. It's number eight, Port of Carly now, joins with Kanazar Jane. This one, a 9-year-old. She's by a wild blue bill. Well, what about it? Just the one down there at the top end on the way home. So it's just the four for Father Carly and Connors RJ. Well, we're going to go now to number nine. From County Clare now, Daisy O'Dea joins us with Gowan Dumare. This one, a French bred owned by Agadoy. Well, what a very nice day there, Kevin D.C.O.D. and the 8-year-old Gavin Dumare. Well, at the moment, five clears as we go to number 10, Rosie McLaughlin. He's next to go over a rough on boy. Thank you. refusal, sir. Bonnie, just a moment. We're going to hold you and we'll give you a new bell. Just one moment, please. So now we're ready. Number 11 now, Bonnie Lockery now joins us with Cornell Stowey. Good form here just last weekend. In fact, they were the winners of the Win 10 Interprovincial here at Barnardown. And prior to that, they were third in the Win 3 Win 10 Masters Final at the Mullingar International. So, number 11, Bonnie Lockery and Cornell Stowey. Oh, that's a very good game, but it's been very consistent as well recently on the run into the qualifiers. They clear for Bonnie Lockery and Cornell Snowy. Well, next to join us in the Childeric Arena, the sponsors of the arena here at Barnardown, it's at number 12 now. Stefano Hernandez joins with Tempest Glembo. This one, a 9-year-old owned by Martina Romanelli. They were good form here as well last weekend. They were sixth in the RDS warm-up class here at Barnardown, which is also an interprovincial qualifier. Well, there, what a pity there. Just the one down, very lucky four there for Stefano Hernandez and Tempest Stempo. Well, we've got number 13 in the ring, Rhino Need now, and Gorto Horka Solvik, another one registered with the Connemara Pony Breeders Society.
Thank you.
one of 83 refusals there, so it is elimination on 4398 today. So now we're ready for Colin Winter, number 14, and Western Oreo. That is here. So another one that will be coming back for our first jump off here for Colin Winter and Western Oreo. So we've now got a 7 clear as we go to number 15. It's Elizabeth McCracken now and Drumcahy Diamond. This one by Sparkling Limited Edition. Elizabeth has decided to retire. Well, next up is Robbie Sheehan now. Robbie joins us with a letter Ben. Of the Glencarrig here. last weekend. That's another one. Now we'll be back for our first jump off clear for Robbie Sheehan and Letter Ben. Now we go to number 18. Eddie Bingham now joins us with the 9-year-old gelding Little Pretender. Was the winner of the Win 10 Bob Sweeney Future Champion Series at Banbridge just last weekend. Lassie, LA is back on our feet so quickly. Well done, Ellie. And please make sure that you go and see first aid. Now next up, and next to join us in the Childeric Arena, it's Reuben Dunham and Beaver Valley. Reuben was fifth with this one in the 110 Masters Final at the two-star international Mullingar. Also winners of the 110 Bob Sweeney Future Champions Series at Ballinrobe, or sorry, at the Meadows. Thank you. 16 jumpy, one time penalty. For number 90. Now we're going to go to number 20, Emily Halford, and Louis Redshank. Combination there for fifth in the 13110 at Cavan just a few weeks ago. Well, unfortunately, one pit stand, so it's just four falls for Emily Halford and Dundee Richard. Well, next up at number 21. Number 21 is the Union Kelly and Future Memories. They were fourth in the 115 Banneral Pony Premier Series at Cavan. That was just 2 weeks ago. Well, and that is clear. It's clear for Union Kelly and Future Memories. We've now got nine clear so far, with seven to qualify. So nine coming back for the first jump off as we go to number 22. Well, next up to join us in the Solidarity Arena, it's Thomas Barnum and the York Addy. There were six just last weekend here at Barnedown in the interprovincial qualifier. Well, it's a two fences down, so it's going to be 8-4 for Thomas Meyer and Joel Paddy. Well, it's 9 clear as we go now. That's number 23, David Duffy. He's next up with a little red barn. David, that's a decided cover time. Well, our thanks to Jill Derrick, who have taken over the sponsorship of this arena here at Barnard Dam as we go to 25 Dam, Helen Walsh and Sergeant Jack. Well done, Helen. We're going to see you in our first step off there for Helen Walsh and Sergeant Jack. That's 10 clear so far. Well, as we said, 10 clear as we go now to number 26, Gloria O'Neill, and joins with the 13-year-old gelding, Zoltan Noble. Oh, what a pity, Claudia. Unfortunately, not your day today, but good to see you back on your feet. So well done. So make sure you go to first aid when you leave the ring. Well, we're going to go next to number 27, Anna Moore now from Corty Cork. Joins us with BBS TikTok. And this one, just an 8-year-old. He's a gelding by Ars Vivendi. But we're glad to see you're okay and I'm back on your feet so quickly. And you make sure you see first aid when you leave. We're going to go now to number 26 is Zoe Bagnallum and MLH or Bertie. Well, just the two down there, so just the 8 for Zoe Bagnum, then by the top 30. We're going to go now to number 29, Lexi Tracy, and the French bred Atelier Durand. Nation has finished off 5th in the 110 interval to qualify a clear equestrian just last weekend. Well, there's four jumping fences, but there's also one time fence for Lexi Tracy and Natalia Duron. We've got a number 30 with us, James Cleary and Matilda. At the moment, 10 clear in our 1-3 RDS qualifier with 7 qualifying places up for grabs. So 10 so far coming back for our first jump off. Well, just the four there, for Jim Cleary and Matilda. Well, we're going to go to number 31 now. Sarah Marty now joins us with Sparkling Co and Moon. That's on the 9-year-old gelding. Fifth at the Bob Sweeney Equine Future Champions Series up at Banbridge just a few weeks ago. Well, it's 8 for Sarah Bargy and the Sparking Kiowa Moon. Well, on we go here in the Childeric Arena. It's Hannah Rose now, number 32. Hannah Rose Rose and Hop. Good form here last weekend. They were fifth in the 110 warm-up RDS qualifier class. Thank you. I'll finish you up on the score of 8-4. Hannah Rose, row 10, hop. But up, we go to number 33. At the moment, 10 clears. And now 1-3 at RDS qualifier. Next up, Lucia Keenow and Alta Dufanard. This one is French bred. Winners of the 110 Grand Prix at Cavan just a few weeks ago. What a very good run, and it's in very good form recently as well. That's Lucia Keen clear with the stallion. He's a stallion as well, Alta Dufanard. So that makes it 11 clears now. So next to go here in the Childeric Arena, number 34, James Ryan, and the 7-year-old, Happy Harry. Here's another one registered with the Connemara Pony Breeder Society. And they were fourth here just last weekend here at Barnadown in the 110 warm-up class.
Anna, just work them for a minute, yeah? Sure, walk under a few of your lines and just swap a pole.
Well, it's all of 20 plus 5. Now, we're going to have to wait for a moment because we need to replace a pole.
Get them nice and relaxed. Alana? Give him a little pat, canter up the fence too, stop him, you know, in front of it, yeah? Just relax him there. Then get your rhythm when you start.
Yeah. Now, next up, number 35, Alana Keeley now joins with Tina Sunshine. Alana was fourth with this one in the Master Speed class at the Bonnegar International at the end of May. Well done, that is clear. So clear for Alana Keeley and Tina Sunshine. That's 12 stairs, 7 to qualify. So let's go through to our first jump ball. Now, next up, it's Ryan O'Neill and Jenny Skywalker. This one just a 9-year-old. Well, just went down, a very unlucky four there for Ryan O'Neill and Jenny Skywalker. Well, next up it's Ronan Galbury. Ronan, in fact, is qualified for Dublin, and he's going to go next with the 16-year-old Bellevue Moor Clover. Winners of the Bob Sweeney Equine Future Champions at Headford. Also, they were third in the sprint trial final this year at Bonnegar. here for Roland Kilvary and Melvin Moore. Melvin Moore Clover, as we said, already qualified, but that makes it 13 tiers now. Now we go next to Harry O'Callaghan. Harry joins with the Frenchman Et Hop Du Noël. And a good result with this one at the Cavan June 2-day Pony Premier Show. They finished a fourth in the 1-3 Grand Prix. Well, they took big two time penalties for Harry Callan and Et Hoc Du Noël. Well, it's 13 clears as we go down to number 39. Georgia Bromwood is up next. She's already qualified and she takes up now the 7-year-old gelding Kyla Ace. Pierre McConnabara, registered with the Connemara Pony Breeding Society by Shannon Fritz. That's a very good round indeed. That one just a 7-year-old here for Georgie de Bromme and Kyle East. We're going out to number 40, 46 go to start here in our qualifier. We're at number 40 now. Jack Dorr joins us with the Sapien Breeze. Thank you.
professional anyway.
Oh dear, Jack, after a really, really good round of jumping, just the very, very last one down. What a very unlucky four there, but Jack Doyle's deep in breeze. Well, next to join us in the Kildare Arena, it's Alice Harper now. Alice talks with a Denneville surprise. And Alice in a good form here last weekend, apparently. They were second in the 110 interprovincial qualifier. What a pity. Unfortunately, elimination there, but could see Alice back in her feet so quickly. Well done, Alice.
What was my pace like when you had any
of you got a bit fat.
Yeah.
You want to be a hole higher, yeah? And Jeff Jack is more sport for you. You want to see back at the
so we're going to go now to number 42. Sergio lead up, joins us with the 7-year-old Carnhill Rod. This one by Woodman Sammy. And them also well bred by the popular ponies are Moore's Clover. Oh, well done, that's a clear on number 14 clear for Sersha Alila Carnhill Rod. Through to our first jump off. There's four left to go in the first round. Next up, Grace Gerhey now joins us with Ebony G. Thank you. Well, as four jumping fencing, one time fencing for Grace Kerry and Ebony G. Next up is Lucy McCarthy now, and Lucy joins with the 10-year-old gelding, 50 Shades. Second here last weekend in the 110 at Barney Down. Fifth prior to that, the Pony Premier at the Meadows. The Pony Premier here is co-sponsored again this year by Ballon Row. Well, here's another one we're going to see in our first jump off. It's there for Lucy McCarthy and 50 Shades. Well, just 2 minutes ago, we've got our second last one with us now. It's Will O'Connor, and she joins with Tullery Casanova. This one is a 8-year-old. He's a stallion, owned and bred by Clive Swindell. By Poetic Justice. Another one here registered with the Connemara Breeders' Pony Society. After a really, really good run, and it's just the last one done. That's so lucky, Willow. So just a 4 for Will O'Connor and Tullery Casanova, and that one just a 8-year-old stallion as well. Now we're down to the final one in the first round of our RDS qualifier. David Duffy now joins us with RDS. It's Brittany. This one, in fact, just a 6-year-old. Thank you. Well, that concludes the first round. We have 16. 16 comes back for the first jump off. That is not against the clock. If we need to, we will have a third round, a final round, which would be against the clock, a second jump off. So, as we said, coming up for you, our first jump off. So the jump off course for the first jump off would be on the 1, 2, 3, 4, 8, 5, 11, 12. 1, 2, 3, 4, 8, 5, 11, and 12. The length of the course, 245 meters. The time of that, 42 seconds, and time limit, 84 seconds. Doyle, if we could have you at the judge's box, please. Now, just a recap on the jump-off course. Fences 1, 2, 3, 4, A, B, 5, 11, and 12. The length of the course, 245 metres, and the time allowed, 42 seconds. Now, this is our first jump-off. We may have to go to a third round to decide the qualifying places. So first to join us is Josephine Dean and Ramiro Van Hed. Over, let go. Oh dear, what a pity. Just the last one down, a very lucky four there by Joseph Mendel and Ramiro Van Hed to Valada Gold. One last go in our first jump off. Joshua Broderick now. And the Hector Death Effort. Thank you. I'll hear what it is. That's the second last one to answer. It's going to be four for Joshua Broderick and a Hector Des. Well, we've got the third one in here in our first jump off. Sarah Egan up joins us with the Rebel Gaelic. Four jumping 21 times, please. It's one for one in this jump off. Well, still looking for our first pair here in our first jump off in our 1-3-8 audience qualifier. It's up Keenan McAvoy now, and it's what you should say. Well, there is our first pair in our first jump off. Pair for Keenan McAvoy and the Trois du Chenet. Now, next to join us from County Clare, here in the Childeric Arena, Daniel Dina and Gowan du Marais. Here, another one having that last one done. That's a very unlooking four there for Daisy Lee. The time 40.96. Well, at the moment, just the one clear in our first jump off. As we go next with Bonnie Lochrane up and Cornhill Snowy, number 11. Thank you. I'll finish you up there on 8 pounds for time 37.96 for Bonnie Lockray and Cornhill South. Still just one PM in our first jump off. As we said, 16 coming back for the second round, but two of them already qualified. Now, if we go to number 14 next, Kalawecha and Western Oreo. Well, it's only our second here, of the second round, so it's here for Callum Witcher and Western Oreo. So at the moment, just two clear.
I know that.
Well, next we go in our 138 RDS qualifier here in the Kildarek Arena. It's Robbie Sheehan now and Little Band. Well, that is clear. It's clear for Robbie Sheehan and Letter Pen. So, that's our third here in our first jump off. Left to go. Eight left to go, but two of them are already qualified. So it's getting exciting here, Dan. And we've got to number 21 now, Unit Kelly and Future Memories. Thank you. just one down there at the double, so it's going to be four for a unit, Kelly, and future memories. So still just the three cleared in our first jump off. There's seven qualifying places up for grabs. So next up at number 25, Helen Walsh now and Sergeant Jack. Well, I was very unlucky. Second last one down. So just the four for Helen Walsh and Sergeant Jack. So six left to go. Two already qualified. Just the three cleared in our first jump off. Next up, Lucia Keane now joins us. And with Ultra Dufanan, that's one stallion. Well done, that is clear. That may prove to be a very valuable clear. Roland Gilvary with a snap. He is a fighter already qualified, joins us this time with Belvoir Moore Clover. Well, finishing up on a score of 8 faults, in a time of 37.13, Ronan Gilvary and the Bellevue Moore Clover. Well, next up in our first jump off here, Alana Keeling and Tina Sunshine.
Oh.
Well, that's 8 fault there for Alana Keeling, the time of 37.27. Left to go, and at the moment we have 4 clears in our first jump off. So next to go, already qualified, Georgia de Bromes up and Kyle Ace. Four jumping, one time penalty for Georgia de Bromet and Kyle Ace. Two left to go in the second round of our 138 RDS qualifier here in the Childeric Arena. Now we're down to the second last. It's a Sergio Neelam. And the search joins with Karen Hill Rod. What about finishing on 4? For Sasha Neal and Carnhill Rudd as we go to the last one here in the first jump off in our 138 RDS qualifier. Lucy McCann, the last to go, and 50J. Thank you. number 12 jumping 5 and time falls for Lucy McCarthy and 50 Shade. Now, we've got just 4 clears after the second round. So at those four, if you would go to the starter and let them know if you want to have a third round. Just being informed from the warm-up, the fourth years would not be coming back for a third round. So that concludes our 1-3 audience qualifier. So we're just going to check the scores here. The four that appear have followed, and we're just going to check the three following qualifying stages. The next class coming up here in the Kildarrick Arena is the 1-3, 6 and 7 year olds. You need to go to the starter to collect your numbers. Please go and collect your numbers immediately down at the starters in the warm up. We can give you the 7 qualifiers for Dublin, subject to confirmation. So, having jumped 3 rounds in the second round, Kiana McAvoy and Etwadu Chesine, also qualifying Colin Widger and Western Oreo. Robbie Sheehan and Detra Ben. And our four clear in round two was Lucia Keane and Atta Dupanar. They're the four clear. Now the fastest four footers also qualifying in fifth, number 42, on a time of 37.52. That's Saoirse O'Neill and Carnhill Rodge. In sixth place, number 25, four falls in time 38.19. That's Helen Walsh and Sergeant Jack. And the final qualifying place goes to number 7, Tina McAvoy and Etoile Duchesnay, clear 39.96. So in fifth, number 42, sixth, number 25, and in seventh, number 21. So Michelle Murphy joining us on behalf of the grand jury for the presentation. To our seven qualifiers, well done to all of you. Tina McAvoy. Colin Widger. These are our clears from round two. Robbie Sheehan from County Kilkenny and Lucia Keane. Fifth, number 42, Saoirse O'Neill and Carnhill Rodge. In sixth place, Helen Walsh and Sergeant Jack. And in seventh place, Eunan Kelly and Future Memories. Well, I think we should have a lap of honour from our top seven who qualified for Dublin. Let's give it a big round of applause. Tina McAvoy, Carla Widger, Robbie Sheehan, Lucia Keane. Natasha O'Neill. Helen Walsh. Una Kelly, we're going to see in action in Dublin this year. We'll be back with the next...